Hello, and welcome to Game Pickups number 48. Today, we're bringing to you 91 games. 91. 90 freaking one. That's what's right in front of me. It looks beautiful, doesn't it? Beautiful. Beautiful to look at, not so much to have a Game Pickups video with. Too many games is an understatement. And let's not even get started on the accessories. Oh my goodness. So, strap in for a long one, ladies and gents. This is going to be beautiful. Now, you might notice something a little bit different behind me. Whoa. Yes. It was going to be 90, but then I remembered I've actually been playing a game for the past 2 weeks. 2.5 weeks. I don't know. I've just become conscious. I've just been... Yeah. Wait, did I count these?
Yeah. Yeah, you did. You
sure?
Yeah.
Okay. 91. Definitely 91, I swear. But anyway, I got a bunch of game pickups, got a bunch of accessory pickups, got a bunch of games, and yeah, I still have a problem. And it's only going to get worse because I've ordered more. Yeah, all these are pretty much all, most of them are eBay auction. But it's only so bad because I haven't actually done a game pickups video for the past 2 weeks, have I? So yeah, I did make one. Like last week or the week before, but I never released it because I was so engrossed with Fallout, I'm sorry. So I figured, fuck it, start all over again. So you might possibly see a duplicate from before 2.5 weeks ago, I don't know. I don't think so, I hope not. Because I've just been so busy, I just haven't had a chance to get rid of a couple of these things. So let's get the accessories out of the way first, right? Right. So, this one I'm going to get out of the way real quick, because I think I've already shown it to you guys. I'm not too sure. It's just a little Dreamcast controller. It's been there for maybe 2 weeks now, so it might have been there in the Game Pickups video 1 or 2 ago. I don't know. So I'll quickly just throw that out and just be like, yep, I got another Dreamcast controller somehow, somewhere. This one I also got, an original NES controller. I can't remember if I've showed you that either, but I love the NES controller. It's absolutely fantastic, and now that I know I've showed it to you guys, I can finally shove it on a shelf. And yeah, it's definitely an NES controller. Right, because I bought something off eBay. And you guys know what I'm like with my little arcade sticks and stuff. Oh, that clicking is so good. He put it down as a Nintendo 64 Quickshot controller. I was like, but the Nintendo 64 has more than just A and B. I'll take a gander. So I bought it and yeah, it's an NES controller. Yes, indeed it is. So I'm not complaining just because I absolutely adore this controller. It's absolutely beautiful. I love it. Not a big fan of the start and select buttons. It's very reflective. Your autofocus is going to die. I apologize. But yeah, it's got an auto fire, which is pretty darn cool. It's probably going to break, though. I really don't like the buttons. It's sticky as well. It's sticky underneath. It's not sticky on top, by the way. God, I wouldn't touch it if it was sticky. Would you? So yeah, got myself a little arcade-type NES, Atari type. Ooh, these are clicky as well. Ooh. Clicky, clicky, clicky. Because I get annoying playing the game. Yeah, Speed King controller. No idea. Bought it for a couple of quid off eBay. No one else bid on it. I won. I was happy. So, yeah. Win. Quick little show here. I finally went ahead and bought a little screwdriver. A screwdriver? What's this? How's this gaming related? It's a game bit. It's a game bit. Screwdriver with the two bits, with the large one and the smaller one. Can't remember the names. Why should I? You can blame Slashbite for this because we're watching him non-stop in the mornings. It's just so good to watch. Twitch.tv/Slashbite. I'll probably have a link to him in the description. I made a tweet out to him, so if you look on Twitter, you'll find a link to it there as well. Really, really good. He just does retro refurbishing. He just grabs himself a little SNES game, opens it up, and just cleans it with rubbing alcohol and all that good stuff, you know. Just makes it all refurbed and pretty, and he does a whole bunch of retro accessories, consoles, games, all that good stuff. It's just really great to watch. And he also does, like, Game Boy stuff as well. And he also broke a Game Boy screen. We'll never let him down on that. It was beautiful. So, yes, I finally got some game bit, and I'm going to get myself some rubbing alcohol at some point. I'm going to start cleaning all these absolutely disgusting games, because some of them are actually quite grubby. I should have faced them the other way. Now I feel bad about buying them. I'm terrible. So I'm just going to show all these together. Because they're pretty much the same thing. I bought five of these things. What are they? Guess. I don't know. Guess what they are. I don't know. Oh, yeah, the VMUs. Yeah, I got five for a couple of quid. I have no idea if they work. It does say they work, but I was like, eh, okay. One of them even comes with a little dust protector thing, which is kind of neat. This one's blue. There you go. I'm very descriptive. But yeah, I have no idea if they work. They all seem to have batteries in, so I'll have to check those first to see if they actually still function. I don't want them all bloody melting on me. I don't know if the button cell ones actually do melt. I ain't got a clue. But anyway, yes, I got five extra VMUs for my Dreamcast. So, you know what I'm like with memory cards? I'm going to have fun with these. Plus, I need to get more games to fill them all up. Yeah. Do I have any more accessories? Yes, I have. Oh, we'll just save that one till last, I think, because that can segue onto that. Right, fair enough. Anyway, I got this for a couple of quid. It's a little scratched and, you know, it's a little worn on the corners, but it is one of those limited edition Mario vs. Donkey Kong Game Boy Advance SPs. Now, I never had a Game Boy Advance SP. I was one of those people that was like, why would I buy an Advance when I've already got one? And then I got my sister's, so then I got two. So I was like, why do I really don't? But I figured it was a couple of quid. It was limited edition. I saw the buy it now prices on eBay. I was like, yeah, and Amazon as well. I was like, yeah, I think I'll bid on this. And I won. And I was like, yeah. And then I was pleasantly surprised to find it had a battery built in. I didn't know much about it. All I knew is it had a backlit light. But you could charge it with original DS cable. Now, I found one for my mother's DS, which was pretty cool, so I used that one. I used that cable because she didn't use it, she didn't even play on it. And yeah, I charged it up, and yeah, it's gonna be some goodness on here with a nice backlit controller. Oh yeah, works perfectly. Played a couple of games on it, and how I managed to play some games on it without getting them all out the cupboard, yeah. Also came with a little baggie, and inside is three Game Boy Advance games. Yes, we're segueing onto the games, partially. So I got another accessory to show. The first little game we picked up for the Game Boy Advance is The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King. It's actually really pretty darn fun. I actually really enjoyed playing that one. It's by EA, obviously, because they make all the Lord of the Rings games, more or less. Except, I don't know if they made or published the Fellowship of the Ring, or was it The Hobbit? I think it was The Fellowship of the Ring. I can't remember. Either way, Peter Pan, the motion picture event. No idea. I tried playing the game, and I was like, okay. And I haven't had a chance to test this one out yet, but X-Men 2, Wolverine's Revenge, which we already have on other consoles somewhere, but obviously it's going to be a way different game, because this is a 32-bit system. I think it's 32-bit. Yeah, X-Men, Wolverine, Revenge, you got all the focus? Yeah! So, yes, that's three Game Boy Advance games we managed to pick up. I'll put them back in the baggie before I lose them, because you guys know what I'm like when it comes to bloody showing things again. Like, I don't know if I remembered I showed you this, but it wasn't in the bag, so there you go, it's in a little baggie. The Game Boy Advance SP! Awesome. So, last accessory, I believe. Well, actually, we'll get the elephant out the room first, won't we? The game I've been playing for 2.5 weeks. The reason why I've been MIA. I even stopped live streaming because I was just getting that into the game, and I was getting into the story, so I didn't really want to spoil it, because the whole reason people were watching me in the first place is because I wasn't doing much story, because I didn't really want to spoil anyone's experience, and I wanted to show them the game. So, yeah, screw that. I just played the damn game and went straight through. Not even completed it yet. Not even close. So yes, Fallout 4. It finally arrived. You may have seen my quick unboxing. So you guys should know I already had it. And plus, it's Fallout. I've been going on about it in all the game pickups forever. But yes, the Pip-Boy edition did arrive. There's the Pip-Boy up there. Of course, I need to put the little thingy back in it, because I'm not going to wear it all the time as much as I want to, because knowing me, I'll break it, and I'll be like, boo, 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 boo. So yes, it finally arrived, comes with its lovely little poster and game, and yeah, you guys should have seen all this. If you want to see more about it, and the hilarious intro that I made for it, you guys should laugh, a whole hearty, very laugh when you watch it. Watch the unboxing of Fallout 4. It's really, really good. Shut up and watch it. You know you like it. Okay, last accessory. We've got that one out of the way. been playing. I just can't stop playing it. It's not fair. This. What is it? Do you guys have any idea? What could it be? It's got zero branding on it. I don't know. What system is it for? It is a converter, more or less, for the Nintendo 64. Now, you guys know that I can play any region game on the NES, SNES, and Mega Drive Genesis. I can play any of them, more or less. I can even play the Famicom if I have the right accessory to convert them. Not bought one of those yet because I've got a ton of Famiclones, and I'm not too bothered about that just yet. But I have been finding quite a few Nintendo 64 Japanese and, you know, American games that I wanted to pick up, but I couldn't because I can't play them, and now I have the means to. Somehow, not tested it out yet, but according to the guy I bought it from, it was only a couple of quid, so I wasn't too that bothered. But you put this end in, and one of these, or maybe both of them, play foreign games. I'm not too sure. I don't know which one is which. I don't know how it works, but he said he used it to play Japanese games on a PAL, European PAL, UK, Nintendo 64. So, I've got one of those. Let me know if you know anything about it, because it's absolutely unbranded. I have no idea who made it. The only way I could probably find out how or who made it is by opening it. And even then, there's no screws on it. So it's probably glued shut. I have no idea. Very peculiar, that one. But, yeah, let's segue us into the 80-odd games I have to show you now. 86, I think. I don't know. We had 91 in total. So, let's go for it. I didn't even count that as a game, by the way. So it would have been 92 if I counted that as a game. Let's just get started. Oh yeah, Peter Pan came with the manual. I'm going to chuck that in the box because I hate loose manuals and I don't want to lose them or get rid of them. So I put them all in a manual box, dedicated manual box for everything. I just keep the manuals of everything. So yes, moment you guys have been waiting for. Let's soldier on through. Right, there's that one and that one, that one, that one. Okay, I won't do that. First one, Batman with half the label ripped off. Makes me feel sad. But you guys, it's Batman of the Future, Return of the Joker. You guys know I love Batman Beyond. So freaking good. I love Batman Beyond, and having a video game dedicated to that is awesome. I think I've already got this on PS1, maybe? I'm fairly certain I picked it up recently, because you know, guys, I know how much I love my Batman Beyond, so Batman of the Future, Return of the Joker, awesome. That was a really, really good movie. Was it a movie? I think it was a movie. But it was really good. I kind of actually really enjoyed it, so yes. Batman of the Future. Let's just make a big, massive pile that is going to fall over, probably, eventually. I got the iconic one, yes. You guys know GoldenEye 64, 007, you guys know. You know all about this. This is like the first game you think of when you think Nintendo 64 first-person shooters. As soon as someone says that, name a Nintendo 64 first-person shooter, the first one they think of is GoldenEye 64. It's a fantastic shooter for the time, and boom. I think I even have the sequel to it. Possibly. Maybe. Or maybe it's on the way. I'm not too sure. Ooh. Yes. But yes, GoldenEye 64 on the Nintendo 64, because awesome, and I'm going to try getting through those as quickly as possible. The obvious ones should be easy enough to explain, and the ones I just don't know because they're all Japanese and I don't understand. So bear with me. Next one, Dark Rift. Looked fun. Looked pretty darn cool. Picked up Dark Rift for Nintendo 64. Autofocus is feeling a little bit angry today, isn't it? I wonder if I could poke around with that. Let's see. Shrup. Whoop. Just do that a little bit. There we go. Yeah, Dark Rift for the Nintendo 64. It's in good nick. It's not got that horrible yellowing problem, thankfully. I don't know. Half these games, I can't remember what they are because I've had them for like 2 weeks. And obviously, I'm going to forget the gameplay I saw. So, I'm only going to remember some of these. But yeah, Dark Rift for Nintendo 64. It looked fun. All these games I've bought looked fun. Unless they were dirt cheap. And I know which ones they were. Next one. Turok Rage Wars. You guys know how much I love my Turok, because who doesn't like dinosaurs? And dinosaurs and monsters. Fun. Shooting dinosaurs and monsters. It's just fun. fun, fun, fun. And I think I got the sequel to this. Ooh, I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. Because I don't know. I got two piles of games. And, yeah. Next one, Shadow Man. Got this. I remember this one because I wanted it for... What console was it on? I don't remember. PS1 or PS2, maybe. Not too sure. But Shadow Man for Nintendo 64. Very fun little game. I don't know. I can't remember what it is. Don't forgive me. You're going to have to forgive me because I completely forgot it. And I know I've wanted it. I've wanted it for ages. And I just couldn't find it for a good price. And then suddenly, boom, I won an auction for a couple of quid. And I was like, always less than the buy it now. Always less than all the buy it nows, which makes me so happy. And it's always so worth it because I'll just point a laugh at the people that buy the buy it now. Here's this one. Now, for this is my first testing game for the converter. And what a game it is indeed. You guys might not know what this is, because you probably don't understand what the writing says, but I know what one of them says. It's Tamagotchi. You guys know Tamagotchi. Basically, it's like a Tamagotchi puzzler type game, I think. I know the other one is more, there is another Tamagotchi game, and that is more of a Mario Party clone, which is pretty cool, I guess, but it's all in Japanese, so I won't understand it anyway. But, yeah, this one, you look after your own little psychopath thing, and you play little games. I can't remember, but definitely got to give it a go and see whether it works, just because I love Tamagotchi. Everyone loves Tamagotchi in the past, and, yep, I got the sequel, Turok 2. Turok 2, Seeds of Evil, a fun little shooter where you run around killing dinosaur monster things with guns, because it's fun, and I love my Turok, because we need more. Next, Jet Force Gemini. Is this that one was that was a platformer? I can't remember. Jet Force Gemini. I tried picking this up a couple of times before, but I just couldn't find a decent copy of it. Then suddenly I did, which was pretty darn cool. So Jet Force Gemini for Nintendo 64. You know it's good. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to move these games out of the way because I've just noticed a couple more Nintendo 64 games that I want to show in the Nintendo 64 segment. And I'd rather show them than not show them. Until later, right? So let's get them out of the way first. This one is really, really sought after and was probably one of my favourite games on Nintendo 64. Banjo-Kazooie! Fantastic platformer. Absolutely brilliant. Yet another action platformer that has been depreciated over the years. So much so, there is now a spin-off with that chameleon guy. Can't remember the name of it, but I've been following it and it's pretty darn cool. It's just a spiritual successor to it, so... Looking forward to playing that when it comes out, but first, Banjo-Kazooie on Nintendo 64. Now this, the guy sent it in this box, yeah? And it didn't have an insert. It just had the game in it all floating around and banging around. I was very upset about that. I was like, that's just stupid. Like, you couldn't at least just buy one. So what I did, because I've had this about a week now, what I did is I bought one of those cardboard inserts off eBay for, I think it was like £2. And it took me about half a minute to figure out how to do it. I was like... Oh, well, you do this! Because it was just one piece of cardboard and I had to open it up somehow. I did it, I managed it, and... Yeah, now the game is now finally nicely seated in the Banjo-Kazooie box. So, yes. It doesn't come with the manual, unfortunately. I was a little disappointed by that. But, hey! I got Banjo-Kazooie in a box. Can't complain about that. Now, here's one I might have shown you before. It's been on the floor for a while now. I'm part of the problem. And I need to store games a little bit better, don't I? Fighter's Destiny, a fighting game. It's just a fighting game. A really good one by the looks of it. It looks fun, it comes in the box, and it comes with the manual, which is always nice and tasty. Always makes me happy when a game comes with the manual. And now I can't get the manual back in because, you know, why would I want to show you something if it won't go back in the box? So I'll put that back in later when I actually get some shelf space for it, which will be soon because I've ordered yet another shelving unit, but not to actually put up. I'm actually using the shelves to make actual shelf space on the shelves. I know. It's got to that, hasn't it? Because I figured why take up more room with another shelving unit when I could make more room on the shelves with more shelves. And unfortunately, it won't actually give me shelves, which I was really disappointed about. So I have to actually buy another one. But hey, Black Friday. That was yesterday. It was awesome. But yeah, next one. Top Gear Overdrive racing game. A little 3D racing game, a little fun one by the looks of it. I did actually quite like the look of this one. I remember enjoying what I watched. I can't quite remember it, but I do remember a positive feeling about watching it. I was like, that's actually a really good looking racing game. So I figured I'd pick that up. Next, Ocean GT 64. I think I looked up this. I think I got this in like a bundle. A little few games bundle, a little racing bundle. It was for a couple of quid. I wasn't going to complain. I think I enjoyed like looking at it. I can't remember. So yes, GT 64 Championship Edition. It's just another racing game. Awesome, right? Next. You know I got these dirt cheap. Let's see if I can grab all the dirt cheap ones first. I don't know. But first we'll go through Perfect Dark. Now I have Perfect Dark Zero, and I knew Perfect Dark Zero was a sequel or a prequel to this. And it wasn't as well received. I can't remember that one, but I figured I'd pick up the original Perfect Dark because, you know, Perfect Dark. Apparently it's an 18. The sticker's just been stuck on. I could take that off. It's not an 18 anymore. But yes, Perfect Dark. I don't know what the gameplay's like, but I know it was like a stealth action type game a little bit. Can't quite remember though. It was a while ago that I looked at it because I did order it a while ago and it came not too long ago actually. It took quite a while to get here. Just picked up a couple of manuals now. Now these two came together, so I figured I may as well show them together. I can't quite remember them, but I remember them getting them because they were so worth buying for the price. I got both of them for about £6 together. So £6 together, and like the buy it nows together were worth like nearly 20 quid or over 20 quid, I can't remember. So I got a really good deal on it. The first one I'm going to show is Hexen. It comes with the manual. Yeah, not the box unfortunately, but it does come with the manual, so I'll put these in the little manual box to keep it safe. Hexen. Here's the game here. Awesome. And the next one is Hybrid Heaven. Comes with the manual as well. I'm really happy the manuals came with them, I suppose, but so that means I'll just have to find a way to print out a box and construct one. I will refurb everything. I just have to find the time and money to invest in actually refurbing all my games. Because I do want them all to be boxed. I do want them all to be in nice little sleeves. I do want them all to have covers. A lot of the games I have don't have covers. So I would like to print a couple off, but that's going to cost a lot of ink and stuff. So I'm going to have to look a way out. I'm just looking through the manuals real quick to see if they can tell me a little bit about the games. They probably do, but it's a lot of writing and not many images. So, yeah, can't quite talk too much about them because I can't remember. But anyway, I know they were totally worth buying and really sought out for there. So that made me happy. Oh, we'll save that one till last because it's beautiful. This one I've had for a while. I can't remember if I've shown you guys. Same goes for this one. Armorines, I think I've shown you guys before, and Top Gear Rally. Fairly certain I've shown you these before, so I'm just going to quickly go through them now. Armorines is a fun little game, and that's a racing game. Fun, right? Right. These two I got together, and I got them with a couple of SNES games, I think. I can't remember. But hey, we're through all the Nintendo 64 games. First is International Soccer 64. That actually looks pretty darn fun. That's the reason why I got it. I was like, that just looks like a pretty good football game for the time. And this one is one of my very few hockey games. Wayne Gretzky. I feel like I've shown you this before. I can't remember. I'm getting deja vu. Probably because I did the game figures like last week or the week before and didn't release it because of reasons. Wayne Gretzky's 3D Hockey 98. Fun little sports games. They were dirt cheap. All these games were dirt cheap. All of them. Every single one, except maybe for one that I'm going to show you soon. And the last Nintendo 64 game is, I've been trying so hard to get it. Buy it now, you're looking at about, I think it's £13 at the moment, or £13 to £15, buy it now. And all the biddings end about £11 to £12, really close to the buy it now, because they're, you know, they're trying to get a good deal on it, but people are like, no, I'm willing to pay a little bit less, and they're just going, I just couldn't do it. And then, yesterday, it was Black Friday, I didn't even go out, we were planning to go out anyway, and then we realised it was Black Friday, and then not only that, there was a food festival going on. I was like, oh my god, best day ever. We stayed out all day. It was brilliant. I loved it. It was a really good day, wasn't it? We had like hot dogs, noodles, and food, and just Subway, and everything was so good. And yeah, and in the awesome little shop that's in the basement of a building, you know, one of my favourite shops that I buy a lot of games from in my local city. Well, boom, I finally found it for £7.99, and they weren't the only ones to do a Black Friday sale. No, 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 they did it. 25% off. So I got that for six. It's working out. My brain's frazzling. About £6. Going for about £6. How come I couldn't do that? My brain frazzled. But yeah, I got this. £6. £6. Pokemon Stadium. I've been dying so hard to get hold of this. I also want to get hold of Pokemon Snap eventually. I'm still trying to find a good deal for that one somewhere. But not only that, it was $7.99 before the 25% off. And then I got 25% off. And then I had a voucher for it for £2.50, which was absolutely awesome. So I got this, that makes it £3.50 that I got this for. £3.50 I got Pokemon Stadium for. Steal. Win. Can't go wrong. Best day. So anyway, that's Nintendo 64 games out of the way, I think. So let's get... let's just chip away at it. Yeah, let's chip away. Let's do that. Let's get these ones out of the way. Let's get the NES games out of the way. Let's go backward. Let's get more retro. Tiger Hell, fun little helicopter shooter game. I can't remember if this is that really slow 3D one. I can't really remember. Tiger Hell for the NES. Very reflective today. Very fun little game. I definitely picked that one up for, what was it? I think it was $4.64, can't remember. Awesome Tiger Heli for the NES. Can't go wrong, because you guys know how much I love my NES games. I picked up also the classic Bionic Commando. Yes, not the shoddy little remake Bionic Commando. Yeah, I see you. Bionic Commando on the NES. Absolutely fun platformer. I wholeheartedly recommend this. I remember getting this for a couple of quid, which was awesome. Can't go wrong, because you guys know I will get everything super cheap if possible. I will never pay out of my backside for something. And I've just realized I've forgotten a gaming pickup accessory, because I just look down and I see it. Oh, we'll do that after the NES games. McDonald's Land. Because I got that McDonald's game, the Gladiators one, and then I saw this one. I was like, auction, I win. It's a little, a little skateboarding platformer, I think? I can't quite remember. McDonald's Land. It looked pretty neat, I guess, but I like my McDonald's. I love McDonald's. It may be the most unhealthy thing in the universe, and I don't care where the food comes from. I just like my McDonald's. I'm sorry. Part of the problem. And plus it doesn't help that I keep getting bus tickets saying $1.99 on them. Yeah, burgers and fries for $1.99 and then a drink for £1. There's your whole lunch for £3. Can't go wrong. And I don't know if I've shown you this one before, but I found it underneath the desk. My bad. Teenage Mutant Hero Turtles. So yeah, if I've already shown you this, I apologize, but figured I'd make sure I show it you all guys, and then I'll make a massive pile and put them all on the shelves because I'm sick of showing you the same game. So yes, I completely missed this accessory off, partly because it was on the floor because it was too big to put anywhere else. It is a controller by Logitech. The same makers of my speakers. The same makers of my webcam. They made a controller too. Look, the same makers of my gaming wheels. Of course they make controllers. This one is the Logitech NetPlay controller for the PlayStation 2. Now, I'm not going to say how much I got this for because I paid out my ass for it. But I did haggle cash converters down, didn't I? Mm-hmm. I did it. I did what no man can ever do. I haggled down cash converters. Usually they're like, no, we pay too much for that. We're not doing that. But no, haggled them down. I was like, boom, get in. So yes, I haggled them down because they had it for a couple of months. They weren't going to ship it. Not at that price, not even close. So I haggled them down. I'm not going to say what I haggled them down to, but because I still paid too much for it. I realized I was saying, I'll never pay out the ass for something. But then I realized I did. But it's such a quirky little controller. Look at it. It's a regular PSD controller with a freaking keyboard on it. Yeah. But then I realized what they did to make it that way. They're separate. That's cheating, Logitech. You can't do that. So basically, it's just a regular PS2 controller that they made with a keyboard that just slots into it. But it is a really, really neat looking controller. I really am looking forward to playing it. The funny thing is, it's made for like multiplayer typing, isn't it? like the Soldier of Fortune, Half-Life, Unreal Tournament, Red Faction 2, Rune Viking Warlord, and Star Trek Voyager Elite Force. Now, I don't know about the Elite Force one, but yeah, pretty darn neat. I don't know. I have no idea. But yeah, contains UK English keyboard. I think the keyboard might actually work on PC because it's just USB. I would try it. I would try it. And I could probably get this. I can get this controller to work on PC because of the PS2 to USB adapter. Really, really good. I love that adapter. Brilliant. So who knows? I might be able to use this on PC. This could actually be a really good Steam controller. Kinda. Like, if I manage to change the driver from PS2 to USB to emulate 360 with like something like XPad or something like that, I could probably do that. And then use the keyboard. I can actually play games with the keyboard on it. Oh my god. The ideas. But yes, I got that. It's a really neat looking controller. And oh my god. Well, a review's coming for it. You guys know what I'm like. I want to review this damn thing because that's the whole part of the reason I got it, because it's a really good controller. So yes, let's get back to the games before I dawdle too much. Right, there, and oh yeah, another NES game. My first ever and only, so far, boxed copy of an NES game. This one's called Swords and Serpents. Sorry, on the listing, the guy put Serpents instead of Serpents. I'll never let him down for that. So, yeah, it's a very fun little RPG. Like, you're going through a dungeon, and apparently it's like 1-4 player. Oh, it's even made by Interplay. Of course, it's an RPG made by Interplay. Brilliant. The box could be in better condition, but it's showing its age. I mean, what year? Go on, give us a year. 1990? Yeah. Talking 25 years now. So, quite old, but it comes with the manual, it comes with the game, and it also comes with my first ever, yet another first, NES game in a sleeve. Awesome, right? So yeah, Sword and Serpents, really darn good. It even shows Arch Rivals on the back, and I'm fairly certain I picked that up at some point. So that's pretty darn cool. Yeah, but yeah, it's a very fun looking RPG. I think I got it for £5, £6. I should really have eBay up when I go through this. I got this for this amount. That's what I should do, but obviously I'm not going to because I'm lazy. But yeah, Swords and Serpents, I got this dirt cheap compared to how much the bike now is. And it comes with everything. So, win there. Absolute win. And I'm really glad I got it. Makes me happy. Makes me moist. Alright. Let's get through. I don't even think we're halfway yet. We've still got the SNES to go through. We've still got Mega Drive to go through. We've still got PS1, PS2, Xbox. To be fair, most of these are retro. All of these are Nintendo 64 and before, minus PS1, because I know the PS1 was before Nintendo 64, I think. Yeah. Anyway, let's get through all these SNES games. I feel like I've shown you these before because of the last one I recorded, I remember some of these being in it. The first one is Super Fire Pro Wrestling, and the next one is All-Star Dream Slam. Now, these two are Japanese SNES games. They're mostly wrestling fighting games, but you guys know I like my fighting games, and getting a couple more in the SNES is pretty darn cool. And the great thing about fighting games is there's not much to read. So that's part of the reason why I picked it up, because I can't read Japanese to save my life. I don't know a single word in Japanese. I probably should, but whatever. Yes, got a couple of fighting games on the SNES. Should be pretty darn fun. Or an absolute bollock. Another one I picked up is another Japanese game called Nigel Mansell F1 Challenge. Now, I don't know if this one is in English. Hard off 105 yen. Oh, no, 100 yen? I don't know. I don't know what that price page. It just has yen on it. It's a racing game. Again, racing games, you don't have to read much with it. So the only time you have to read something is like, if it's like more of a modern game, and it's got like single race championship and all that good stuff, so I don't know if we've got that in this. But yeah, it's a little racing game for the SNES. Japanese. In the UK, Japanese games are cheaper than everything. I don't understand why. You'd think it costs more because of the import value. It comes all the way from Japan, by the way. It's not Japanese games sold in the UK. They are genuine Japanese games from Japan being sent over to the UK. Cheaper than the UK counterparts. Japan, how do you do it? Tell me. I need to know. The next one is, I was really proud about getting this one. I got it for a couple of quid. £3. I was like, Pack Attack. Yes. Good old Pack Attack on the SNES. I'm still trying to get hold of Miss Pac-Man. I don't think I've got that yet, but oh, maybe I've got that on a multi-cart. I think I do actually, on the Mega Drive. I can't remember. But anyway, Pack Attack on the Super Nintendo, really awesome. It's the UK version, thankfully. Not the really neat. Again, I could get this in Japanese, and it'd just be no different. It'd still be the same Pack Attack game. It actually looks really darn fun. Pack Attack is a very, very different take on Pac-Man, which is really, really good. Pack Attack was a fantastic little game. This is a fighting game, I believe. I don't know the name of it because it's Japanese, and it's literally all in Japanese. I have to. What I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna put a little label on top. Yeah, blasphemy, right? And put the actual name of it, so when I actually put it on the shelf like that, I'll have a little label there telling me what exactly the game is and give me a little short translation of what the hell that means. So I should get out of my way and start doing that soon. Super Famicom, of course. And it's a little fighting game. It looked pretty darn fun when I gave it a quick Google. There's only a couple of videos out there for these Japanese games. Very, very obscure. I'm not saying the rare, just obscure on YouTube. So yeah, another little wrestling game. Super Fire Pro Wrestling. Did I already pick up a Super Fire Pro Wrestling? What's the difference? Oh, this is Super Fire Pro Wrestling something X. Yeah, so yeah, I've got two Super Fire Pro Wrestling. Must have come in the same things. When I buy these Japanese games, they're all in like packs of like three or four. Which is really darn cool. So not only are you getting the games for less than £1 each, you're getting multiple SNES games. It's really good. It's really, really fantastic shelf filler. And plus they're fun little games as well. I'd never buy a Japanese game of something like Gauntlet or what's that other one? Just RPGs basically with lots of writing in. I won't be able to understand them, and I'm not going to buy it for the sake of filling shelves because I want to at least play the games and understand them. That's kind of how I go. I like to fill my shelves, but I also like to fill it with something I want to play, not because if I did want to do that, I'd just grab all the FIFA games in the universe, which I can really cheaply just grab all the FIFA games and just fill up all the shelves. And I'd never do that. I can't be bothered. The other time I did that a little bit was on a PS3, but that was because the games were pennies, literal pennies, and I do want to try them out, more modern ones anyway, which is why I got the PS3 ones. So it worked out all right for me. Another little Japanese game. This one actually looked really darn cool. Zardian. I can't remember it though. It did look pretty darn good though. Zardian. I do like the cover art. The cover art's really, really good. Looks really anime-like. Looked pretty darn neat. I gave it a little YouTube and I remember enjoying what I saw. I couldn't tell you much about the game because again, some of these I've had for over a week and I've just forgot, which is sad. But if you care enough, you give it a quick YouTube now, right? Right. Next, something, 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 Magic Adventure. This was really difficult for me to YouTube, but I managed to find it eventually. It looked pretty darn fun. A little platformer, I think. Looked pretty darn neat. Like sliding down and stuff. I think sliding down, jumping. Can't quite remember. I think that's the one anyway. It was really difficult to find, but because it had Magic Adventure in English in the name, it made finding it on YouTube a lot easier. But apparently, there's like a couple of them as well, so something similar to that, maybe. Oh dear, do I have a couple of these? Because I think I do. Let's get all the little Japanese ones out of the way first. All right, first one is this is a wrestling game. I remember that much, probably. Well, also the image, Asian people. Because, yes, Japan. It's just a fighting game. And NBA Pro Basketball. It's funny, NBA Pro Basketball, and it's all in Japanese. Really weird that. But because it was released in Japan, of course, it was localized for that region. So, yes, NBA Pro Basketball and a little wrestling game. Again, for Japan, really yellowed. Really, really. You can see the color difference there. Really yellowed and really, really dirty on this side. Not good, that is it. No. Needs a good refurb. I think I should get. I'll send him to Slash Buy and get him to refurb them for me. Before I start doing it. I got a couple of SNES left now. I lied. There's a pile there. I lied. Never ending video this. Super Nintendo. Killer Instinct. It's in a black cart. I think it's the only colored cart I've got. I did nearly get hold of a couple of others, but they were. Repros? No, not repros. What's it? Homebrew. homebrew. So they win like really quirky little green cards and all that. It's pretty neat. But yeah, Killer Instinct for the SNES. Can't remember. I looked it up. I liked it anyway. I'm not going to buy a game I don't like. So, hey, I like it. Bet you didn't know about that, did you? And this... I had a mini battle to get this one. Me and this guy were just battling to get all of it. It actually looks really darn cool. I think I remember this one. Super Pang. I don't remember it because I had a little battle to actually get it, because some of the guy really wanted it as well. But I got it for £3.43. Like, it started at 99 and was going up in literal pennies. I was like, no, me, I will win. And then he was going, no. And I was like, nah. And then, like, 10 seconds before the end, I was like... 343, I don't care, boom, and I won. I was like, I'm part of the problem. I hate auction snipers, but if you are serious about auctions, you have to. You have to auction snipe. It's the only way to win without losing too much money. It's a horrible tactic, and it's one I've been reduced to do so many times because I've been auction sniped. All these games I've won in auctions, but double that, and that's how many I've lost as well because of auction snipers. It's just... You feel forced to have to do it, because if you don't do it, other people will do it. So anyway, Super Pang, let's talk about it. It is something like balloons fall or something like that, like balls fall and birds and stuff. They come down. It's like a little bit like Space Invaders, a little bit. You've got to pick something up, and that's your ammunition to shoot up at them, or you shoot string or something to catch them. I can't remember. It looks really, really good, though. It's a really, really fun little game. Very difficult as well, because I think you've got limited ammunition, which makes it even more difficult, which is cool. So, yes, Super Pang, and oh, already the pile's falling. Not even tall piles. They're not that big. I'm making little piles spread out, and it's still falling. Retro games. And let's go through the last pile of SNES. Now, these are separate because, hey, guess what? They're my favorite. They're American carts. I love American cards. First one is Bubsy. Fantastic little platformer. Love Bubsy. So I finally picked that one up by Accolade. And you guys know how much I love my SNES cards. They just look so... SNES American cards. Yeah, USA. SNES. SNS. UI-USA. I love them. I just love these cards. They look so retro and carty. That's really not. That's really awesome. So yeah, next is... Phalanx. This one actually comes with a dust protector. Pretty darn neat. And it will only work with the American versions of the game. So, yes, you've come a long way. Probably all the way from America, maybe. Who knows? Yes, yet another American game. This one is Phalanx. Don't let the picture fool you. It shows some guy with like a banjo and a dog. It actually looked pretty darn fun. And I was like, that name sounds cool. The game itself. Looks cool. I'm going to pick it up. So I picked it all up for a couple of quid. Again, I'm really privileged. Not just because I'm white, but also because I have a console that can play any region games. I have no problem with looking at American games. And because I get American games, people are less willing to buy them because they're region locked. Or maybe they're just not willing to play games from other regions because they want the whole PAL collection or something like that. I don't know, but... Anyway, I feel really privileged to be able to play all these. It's really, really, really good. Makes me happy. So, Super Soccer Champ, little soccer game. It is soccer because it's from America, and I will call it soccer because it's from America. Okay, I'll let you off. Actually, no. I'm not taking it. Actually, I take it back. It's football. Look, when you start using flags from other countries, that's when you start calling it football. Sorry, but there's an England flag, French flag, Italian flag, German flag, American flag. Yeah, I see all those flags at the bottom. I was going to let you off then, America, with the sucker, but then, nope, you ruined it. You ruined it, America, I'm sorry. This one, I partially bought this because it reminded me of Pac-Man, the cover, not the game. Faceball 2000. Sorry, but the little yellow, as soon as I see a yellow ball with a face, I think Pac-Man. It's got absolutely nothing to do with Pac-Man. It just looks like a fun little game, so I figured I'd pick it up. Faceball 2000. Neat little game. Actually, I think the gameplay actually did remind me of Pac-Man. I can't remember. Is it in a maze? I think. Can't remember. But anyway, next. UN Squadron. Now, I did try winning the box copy of this, but I didn't quite succeed. But hey, I got this one instead, and it comes with a dust protector as well. Can't go wrong with that, can you? But yeah, UN Squadron, it's actually a really, really fun flight game. You're flying around, kicking ass. Awesome. Battlefield style. It's made by Capcom as well. Crapcom making good games? Oh, wow. Blasphemy. Yes. UN Squadron. Pretty darn neat. And the last game is Super Battle Tank War in the Gulf. You're controlling an actual tank. A freaking tank. You're going around kicking ass. How awesome is that? So yeah, Super Battle Tank War in the Gulf. Can't go wrong with that one. Let's get on to the next pile. Just the never-ending pile. Never-ending pile. So let's get the boxed copies out of the game. Out of the game first, yes. Boxed copies of the games out of the way first. Now, the first one I'm going to go through first, because I don't know if I got this one for a good price, because I just saw it. I got 25% off, which is cool, so I got this for about $3.75, which is, not bad. It's not bad, especially for a boxed Mega Drive game, so can't go wrong with that. This one is called Zero Tolerance. You don't play this game, you survive it. Yes. Does it come with the manual? No idea. Nope, of course it doesn't. It comes with a big, massive cart, though, which is pretty darn cool. But unfortunately, didn't come with the manual. What made me buy this game was the screenshot on the back. Autofocus. Oh, there we go. Now, what game does that remind you of in the middle? Doom. This smells like Doom all over it. It's got creatures, got a gun in the middle, it's got shooting. I just smell Doom in here. So I'm just like, I want to play this. So yes, you have zero tolerance for the terrorists out there against you. They're in your face. Even put Y-E-R. Your. They're in your face. And they have to die. The first person perspective gives you time to prepare. It's kill or be killed. Pick your weapon or destruction from lasers, bazookas, grenades, and shotguns, and go kick some aliens. Wait, I thought they were terrorists. What the fuck? No tolerance for the terrorists out there against you. Go kick some aliens. This is a 3D adrenaline pumping, 3D 60 degree total combat experience. You don't just play it, you survive it. It still looks cool. It looks a lot like Doom on the back, so I'm really looking forward to playing this one just because of that. And I think it's got a little map on it as well, which is pretty darn cool. So you know where you are. So yeah, I probably got this for a good price. You know, because it was $4.99 originally, 25% off that, which makes it $3.75. So, I don't know, might be worth it. I'll have to have a quick look on the eBay mans later and Amazon mans. This one I got like last week. My bad. It's Jurassic Park. It's a little platformer. You're basically killing and avoiding dinosaurs, of course. It's only one player, unfortunately. It would have been nice to have two player, maybe like. So I like platformers with two player, although it's a little bit annoying. I suppose that's better with beat-em-ups. I don't know. I think I'm confused. A hurricane rips through Jurassic Park Dinosaur Preserve. What? That happened? Trapping tourists and freeing the most terrified. This is completely different to the movie. That's kind of cool. But anyway, yes, Jurassic Park. Does it come with the manual? What do you think? No. How? How'd you lose it? Oh, okay, I'll let you off. No, how do you... You've got little numbers there. Whatever. Maybe someone sold it. They probably did. Next. Space Harrier 2. Yes. Very difficult little game. It's a weird one. Really, really weird one. You're moving around like crazy, but then you've got your guy just moving around the screen like he's actually... Like a side scroller, but it's like 3D. It's not 3D, but it's like moving into the background. It's really, really weird. But yeah. It looks like a fun little game. Does this one come with the manual? Oh my god, it does! It actually does. It comes with the manual. A rare sight to behold. But yeah, this game was a little weird, so I figured I'd pick it up. Why the heck not? And plus the guy in the front, it just says all I need to say about it. I think it was Classic Game Room that made me want to buy this. It's because it just looks so stupid, and I wanted it. So yeah, Space Harrier 2. I picked that up. Naturally, I picked up this. Of course I did. You guys know I already own Mortal Kombat 3? 4? I know I've got 4 on Game Boy. I think I got 3 on the other systems. I can't remember. But anyway, Mortal Kombat. The original Mortal Kombat. Now, apparently, Now, which one's better? Is it the SNES version or the Mega Drive version? I think it was the SNES version. I think, maybe. Not too sure. Or maybe the SNES version was the one that was... what was it? Censored? I don't know. I can't remember. I know there's something behind like the first Mortal Kombat on both of those systems. Either way, deliver Cage's patented Shadow Kick, Liu Kang's Fireball, let the tournament begin, blah, blah, blah. You know, good old stuff. And it comes with the manual, which is absolutely awesome, and the video game, which is pretty darn cool. So, can't go wrong with some Mortal Kombat. Next, T2, the arcade game. The number one arcade smash. Yeah, I think you need the Menacer for this one. This game is playable with the Sega Mega Drive Menacer or standard Mega Drive controller. So you can play it with the regular one, but obviously it'd probably be improved with the Menacer. I am planning on getting the Menacer. I almost got a Menacer the other day. The listing was a collection only, and it was on the other side of the country, and I'd never be able to collect it. So I messaged them asking them if they'd be willing to deliver it, but obviously they weren't happy with my offer price, because the delivery would have costed about £3, and it was worth about a tenner. Now, you can buy the Menacer for about £20, and that's with delivery included, £20, with the whole thing whole. This one, however, had the handle missing, the grip missing. It had the whole gun. The only thing it had missing was the stabilizer that goes into like your shoulder when you're holding it. It was missing that part. So I figured, okay, £13-15, you know, I'm knocking off a nice significant slice of the price. You know, I think that's worth it, you know, £13-15. Because it's missing a very big part of it. But no, they didn't seem happy with my offer, so I was like... And then I looked at the listing later. They didn't get a single bid, so they're stuck with it, and I don't care. They deserve it. So anyway, T2, the arcade game. It's a little shooter game from the arcade. They remade it into the Mega Drive, which is really darn cool. I wonder why they didn't use the Terminator word. Oh, they use it in the description, at least. Terminate the Liquid Metal T-1000. You're a T-800 Terminator with an awesome array of weapons, rapid-fire machine gun, shotgun, rockets. It just looks really darn fun, and I figured I'd really enjoy it if I picked it up. So I picked it up. T2, the arcade game, which is pretty... cool stuff, right? Next, Fantasia. This actually made me want to play it. Watch it, the whole movie again, because I absolutely love Fantasia. Fantasia is one of my favorite Disney movies. This is for the Genesis, not for the Mega Drive. Yes, this is the American version. That's why I got it so cheap. Again, because I was getting away with buying things on the cheap because they're not from the UK. Which is pretty darn cool. So join Mickey Mouse on his most magical adventure ever, Fantasia. You want to search for musical notes whisked away by the evil eye. It's a platformer, basically. A really, really good little fun little platformer. And it's Fantasia. Can't go wrong. Which will make you want to watch the movie all over again. Because it's a really good movie. Next. Cool Spot. Do you come with the manual? Wait, did I check if Fantasia came with the manual? Yes, it did come with the manual. Yes. Fantasia has the manual. Next. Cool Spot. I don't think this comes with the manual. It's too light. And the box went open. Oh my god. What the hell? There we go. Wait, you can't open it from the top, but you can open it from... whatever. Okay, whatever. No, it doesn't come with the manual. It comes with the game. So what is this game? Platformer, of course. No way! Your Cool Spot chums are locked away. Yes, away! You are Cool Spot, and are here to save the day! This description's making me want to kill myself. Quit gawping over the dreamy scenery, the most awesome animation, and the most savory sound around. Play, man, this is the hairiest. What? This game, I swear. So yeah, it's got a whole bunch of levels. It's got 11 levels plus 5 bonus levels, one player, peripherals, Sega control pad, or control stick. Neat. I'll show you some of the screenshots on the back. Really low resolution because, you know, the old games, but yeah, pretty neat little screenshots. Makes you wonder how they did the screenshots back in the day. Yeah, they must have taken a picture of the TV. Because they're different brightness. That one's brighter than that one. So then maybe that's how they got the screenshots back in the day. Interesting. Anyway, that was Cool Spot. Now we have two piles of Mega Drive games. Yeah. Now I have to go through these by memory. The first one is The Beached Surfer Dude for the Sega Genesis. This is actually a really weird little platformer. Like, you're some beach surfer dude on a weird island in, what is it? In the mysterious, Maruda Triangle, is it? I can't remember. But yeah, you're on this little deserted island thing, and you're just platforming, and you swing and stuff, which is really, really cool. Reminds me of Pitfall in that sense. But yeah, Beach Surfer Dude, it's a silly, fun little game. Next is Red Zone. I can't remember this one, so I'm just going to say I own a game called Red Zone. Because I'm not even going to go out my way to try and remember what it is. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. Next is King of the Monsters. Again, a fantastic game. This one is a bit like Godzilla. Any other Godzilla brawler. Basically, you fight all the kaijus in the universe. Naturally, you're going to win, right? So yes, it's just a King of the Monsters. It's just a fighting game. You're fighting in destroyable scenery, I believe. You find like Godzilla and all that stuff. It's really, really good. It's amazing how this game gets it right, and the Godzilla for PS3 does not. Mind blown. But anyway, King of the Monsters, really fun little game. Looking forward to playing that one. This one I picked up recently, and it arrived not too long ago. Robocop versus The Terminator. Oh yeah, really difficult game if I remember rightly, but it's a fun little game regardless, because we've always wanted them to clash. Even from all the way back here, what year was this? 1993. Even from back then, we wanted them to clash. We wanted to see who would win between Robocop and Terminator. Probably Terminator, because, you know, Robocop is so fragile and Terminator is practically indestructible, of course. But hey, I think you play as Robocop in this one and you beat the Terminator up. I can't remember, but I remember it just being difficult and fun. So it should be fun. This I picked up for a couple of quid because it's Mega Game 6, but I don't think it's part of the Mega Pack. You know, the Mega Bundle? You know, the games you can buy, like Mega Games 1, Mega Games 2? I just don't think this is part of that because it's got Golden Axe and Streets of Rage, which I think was in the earlier ones. So I'm not too sure. But anyway, this comes with World Cup Italia 90, Super Hang-On, Streets of Rage, The Revenge of Shinobi, Columns, and Golden Axe. Three of those, I think, were already on some other Mega Games compilations, so I don't think this is actually part of it. But regardless, Mega Game 6 comes with some of the best games on the Mega Drive. Can't go wrong with Streets of Rage or Golden Axe, so this is worth it just for that. Really fun little game. Got it for a couple of quid. Win! Next, Sega Mega Drive, Tengen. Oh no, it's not called Tengen. It's made by Tengen. It's Gauntlet 4. I knew I had Gauntlet in my head. And this is another reason why I'd only buy these games in English. Gauntlet 4. You guys know how much I love my Gauntlet, so naturally I'm going to pick up Gauntlet 4. The cover could be in a much better condition. I might get this refurbed. Get a whole new sticker printed. I do have plenty of sticker paper. It's just, you know, the ink and stuff for it. Yeah, I would really like to replace this one because I do like the cover art of it because it's really good, and I just don't like seeing him in bad nick like that. But anyway, yes, Gauntlet 4. Next, Abrams Battle Tank. This arrived today. Really fun little tank game. You ride around in a tank beating people up, shooting them up, killing them because, you know, you're in a tank. Of course you're in a tank. I don't know why they don't make first-person tank games like this anymore. This was really good back in the day. They should make more tank sections in Battlefield, please. In the single player. Thank you. Much appreciated. Next is The Lion King. Did not buy it for £6. Bought it for like 3 or 4 off eBay. But they kept the original price on to make it think like you were getting a good deal. I should do that. I should just get a ticket machine when I put things on eBay. I'll print something off saying like £12 and be like, here it is for £10. See if anyone falls for it. I didn't fall for it. But yeah, Lion King. It's just a platformer. You play Simba just jumping around like a lunatic. Platforming. So yes, can't go wrong with that. Lion King. I've tried getting hold of it for ages. And I got hold of it a couple of weeks ago and then it arrived. So, win. NBA Live 96. It's basketball. On the Mega Drive. Next, James Pond. And now, you guys know I already own this on the PlayStation 2. Literally this game, James Pond 2, codename Robocod. But it's called, like, codename Robocod James Pond on PS2, which is really weird. I don't know why they did that with the name. But, yeah, it's a very, James Pond is a fantastic platformer, but all the games are very, very different, which is, I don't know why. I think they were all developed by different people, maybe? Probably, I'm not too sure. But yeah, James Pond 2 especially is a fantastic platform, and I definitely recommend it. That's why it was re-released on the PlayStation 2. It's that good. So yes, pick it up. Naturally, I did, because I like owning the original. I believe it was a few quid anyway, so I'll win. And you guys know why I bought this. It's for the Sega Genesis. It is called Arrow and Flash. Why did I pick it up? Do you know why I picked it up? Yep, we all know why I picked it up. Arrow and Flash. It's got absolutely nothing to do with them. Of course it has absolutely nothing to do with them, but because it just caught my eye, naturally, because I'm always looking for Arrow and Flash on the internet, and boom, Arrow, Flash, the game. Can't even remember what it's about, because I bought it a couple of weeks ago, but yeah, it's for the Genesis anyway, so I was like, yeah. I know it's not common. It's not super common anyway. So I managed to get this for a really cheap price, mostly because it was on the Genesis. So yeah, I'm very happy about getting that. So yeah, Arrow Flash for the Mega Genesis. Genesis, getting your head. Fly around in a helicopter and kill people in Gunship for the Mega Drive. It's just another one of those many helicopter flying around shooting people games. It's really, really good, and you can't go wrong. Now, this one I think I've already shown you guys. I'm not too sure if I showed you guys. I think I might have shown it in the last one. So, bear with me. This one is Sonic the Hedgehog 2. I got it from that charity... not charity shop, that Cash Converters. You know the Cash Converters I used when I tested out the camera? But I don't think I showed it you in that video. I think that's why I held this off. I think. I know I didn't show it you in that video. I did show it when I was wearing the glasses. When you saw it in the front, it was there. And I bought it then and there, but eh, whatever. Now, at the time, I thought it was the original Sonic the Hedgehog, but turns out it was Sonic the Hedgehog 2. So I was like, I own it now. So yeah, I'm not sure if I've shown it you, so yeah. This one I picked up for a couple of quid. Pac-Mania for the Sega Mega Drive. I love my Pac-Man. I'm sorry. I'm part of the problem, but at least I didn't buy it brand new back in the day. So how old was I at the time? I wasn't. That's all I'm going to say. How old was I at the time? I wasn't. Yeah, looking at the 2 years on there, I was alive for neither of them. Oh dear. So yes, Pac-Mania for the Mega Drive. Love myself some Pac-Man. One of my favourite ever. Which one's this one? Ooh, dunno. Made by US Gold for the Mega Drive. It's got a sticker on it, but it's been on there for so many years. Official licensed product. Let's see on the back. No. It says Mega Drive Games Band 2. But it doesn't say what it is on the top. I think it's... I don't know. I'm not sure. I didn't buy it for $3.99. I got it off eBay. I'll have to have a quick look on eBay. Oh no, it's one of the games. I don't know what it is. Maybe you guys know what it is. If I remember to, I'll try putting a subtitle here to say what this is. I'll try and have a little troll around on eBay and find out what it is. Sorry about that. My bad. Must have been one of these tennis games. Same label. It's got the same pre-owned $3.99 thing on. This is a tennis game called Davis Cup World Tour. This one is, again, same label, another tennis game. This one's called Andre Agassi Tennis. So, yeah, I think that we can safely assume this is a tennis game, right? There's two tennis games there. So, yeah, I got three tennis games for the Mega Drive, I believe. Either that or it's a football or basketball. It's a sport game. Yeah, I remember this. It's got it in a little bundle pack of sport games for a couple of quid. It always works out about £1.20 for the game. Can't go wrong with a game for just over £1 on a Mega Drive. Just can't do that. And of course, the last Mega Drive game I picked up is, of course, Batman Forever. It is such a bad game, but I got it anyway. For the Sega Genesis, of course. Yeah, Batman Forever. The movie was laughable. The game is more than that. It's just... it's... not good. Das ist nicht gut. Mm-mm. Das ist sehr nicht gut. Mm-hmm. It is terrible. So, yes, Batman Forever. Yeah, it's just a little... I like my Batman! bad. I'm sorry. Even if it's really terrible live-action movies. So, yes, that's all the Metro games out of the way. And guess what? We're not even done yet. We're over an hour in. So let's get these ones out of the way next. I bought these because I wasn't sure if I already had them. I need to go through my gaming list all over again and check and actually put on a label on it saying whether it's got the manual or not. Because the local city's basement game shop has a ton of instruction manuals for 50 pence each. Way cheaper than eBay would ever be. So I got Crash Bandicoot manual, Crash Bash manual, and Croc 2 manual. I don't know if I needed them, but I figured I'd pick them up anyway because, you know, cheap. Really sought after manuals, so I figured I'd pick them up. Now, I'm very angry with them about this one. It's not Revolt. It's a freaking lie. It's Buster Move 4, which I've already got. I was like, oh, Revolt, I don't have that. Okay, I will pick that up. Didn't even think to look at the back, did I? So I partly blame myself for that, but it's really misleading on their part to have it facing this way as I'm flicking through all the discs and just buying Revolt. Nope, Buster Move 4. So that can go on my spare shelf, then I'll try selling that to someone for a quid maybe. I don't know. Anyway, I picked this up for the girlfriend because she likes a GTA, and because it was 50p, I figured I'd get it. Xbox 360 Classics, Grand Theft Auto 4. Indeed. I liked Grand Theft Auto 4. It was very different to all the previous ones. I don't know why they took it in that direction. I think they wanted to be a little bit more serious, but it just... I don't know. It didn't feel right. The game got annoying with all the constant calls from Roman, but otherwise it was a solid game. They really did well with the engine, and you could see what they did with it, because they used the same engine for GTA 5, and they've made it absolutely fantastic, so they definitely built it well. It just wasn't a very great game, and the story was laughably bad. So anyway, that was that. Next is my only Dreamcast game, I believe. Buzz Lightyear of Star Command for the Dreamcast. It doesn't come with the manual, but it does at least come with the cover and the back cover and the disc. It's in a CD case, so I haven't got that going for me, but I would have preferred a full case with the manual, but yeah, what more can you give? Next, I was on the bench. I was like, should I get this for the Nintendo 64 or should I get this for the PS1? Compared to prices, there was like a £3 difference. £3, that's a lot, especially when it's a cheap game. So I picked it up for PS1 instead because I figured I'd show some love for my PS1. So for a couple of quid, I bought Battle Tanks Global Assault. Basically, you're just fighting tanks. It's stunning 3D graphics. Literally 3D engine. Really tiny screenshots, but it is definitely 3D as you can see in that one. Walking around a nice big map, blowing up other tanks. Really fun. Single and two-player cooperative campaign. Blah, blah, blah. Destroy historical buildings, including Big Ben and the Eiffel Tower. That is not a very good thing to say right now. Do you not know about terrorist actions? Bad. Bad. We do not talk about terrorist attacks of the Paris. Bad. God, some games have no respect for, modern times. Terrible. But anyway, Battle Tanks. Fun little 3D tank battle game. Fun, right? Plus, you get to blow up Big Ben. So you get to go play Viva Vendetta in a tank. Next. I kept seeing this one. And for $2.99, I was like, $2.99. But I picked up Delta Force Urban Warfare for less than $2.99 because it's 25% off. So let's go $150.75. So I got it for about $2.25-ish. Yeah. Can't go wrong. $2.25. I can do that. I can do that. A couple of quid for a Delta Force game. I love my Delta Force game. Fun little shooter. The US Army's elite defined by their expert combat skills. And it comes with the manual. Does this come with the manual? Feels a bit light, this one. Battle Tanks, do you come with the manual? You come with a very small manual. Comes with the manual. And this one comes with a manual as well, which is awesome. And again, do you see what I mean? The manual just falls out. So I can understand why the PS1 games don't have manuals, but any other game, especially PS2 and PS3 and Xbox, no excuses not having the manuals. And this one I picked up as well for a couple of quid from the same shop. The Dead Man's Walk is a roll in the park. I have no idea what it is. It just looks different. It's called Moho. Moho. Comes with the manual. And you play as little robots like that. Like rolling a ball. Feel the earth move and crowds roar as the biggest, baddest criminals in the galaxy run riot for their freedom. Smash, slash, claw, and work your way through 80 gladiatorial levels. You guys know I like my gladiatorial arenas, such as Ratchet and Clank Gladiator. Yep, I absolutely loved Ratchet and Clank 2 for the Gladiator arena, and then they made a whole game revolving around the gladiatorial arena. I was like, yes! So, awesome. Moho! Gladiatorial arena. Did it before Ratchet and Clank 2. That's all the PS1 games out of the way. Let's get through. We're on the final stretch. I'm sorry for the long video, but just have to live. Just these to go now. Let's get them out of the way. Let's go through the more modern ones first. Yeah, modern. I can play with modern. Modern's good. Picked these up yesterday. Yes, probably spent more than they're worth. I could have got me cheaper on eBay or something. I don't know. But I figured I'd pick it up. Divinity 2, the Dragon Knight Saga. I like my Divinity. Divinity's fun. The Dragon Knight Saga includes two complete adventures. Divinity 2 Ego Dragons and Divinity 2 Flames of Vengeance. Live the entire adventures of Dragon Knight in the great RPG that includes the complete remastered versions of Ego Draconis. Oh, no dragons. My bad. I can't read. Sorry, but when they use upper font of C's and G's and that looks similar, you just kind of confuse them. And the brand new adventure, Flames of Vengeance. Yay! Two complete adventures for over 100 hours of gameplay. You're going to get completely sunk in this one. It looks pretty darn good, so I'm looking forward to playing it. Divinity 2 for the Xbox 360. Next, this one was quirky. I found it for £3. I was like, it's different. Infinite Discovery. You look like a hero, not act like one. With a fearsome army calling itself the Order of Change, shackles the moon to the earth. That alone made me go... Shackles the moon to the earth. That is hilarious. An unassuming boy named Capel, who bears a startling resemblance to a hero of the people, is hurled into the midst of conflict. Hey, you like a hero. Get out there and show us you're a hero. And then suddenly you turn into a hero. But what got it was, it says, from the creators of Star Ocean. Star Ocean, fantastic RPG and fun real-time combat a lot of the time. And Valkyrie Profile, not too sure about that one. They might have made Valkyrie Chronicles, maybe? Not too sure. Comes an epic adventure RPG featuring exhilarating real-time combat, intense action sequence, and cutting-edge graphics. Not too bad about the graphics, but the game looks and sounds really fun, and it's different. Infinite Undiscovery, not too sure. I'll go for it. And naturally, Dynasty Warriors 7. I've just got one more to get now. One more, and a couple of the Empire's ones as well. We don't care too much about those, because I don't know the difference between them. I don't. Someone's going to have to explain that to me. But yeah, Dynasty Warriors 7 for the Xbox 360. I will get 8 one day. Soon, I will own it. Somehow, find it cheap. I don't know where. But yeah, Dynasty Warriors 7. They know you know what Dynasty Warriors is. That's why they wrote nothing on the back. They know exactly what... you think Dynasty Warriors is. Experience the thrill of taking on entire armies as one of many playable characters from Wei, Wu, Shu, and Jin dynasties. Lead your squad to victory and face insurmountable odds as you realize your dream of reuniting ancient China. Conquest knows no boundaries. Yeah, Dynasty Warriors 7, because what's more fun than just rolling around and kicking people's ass? And naturally, I picked this one up, okay? I already own it on PS2, but I figured I'd get it on Xbox because it was only £1, and I love Star Trek to death. So naturally, I picked up Star Trek Shattered Universe. Really, really good. Battle former friends and foes alike as you journey the perilous journey across a twisted Star Trek universe. The Mirror Universe, I believe. All hands to battle stations. Basically, you fly around. Basically, you're in like a fighter jet. You're flying around the Enterprise kicking ass. Really, really flipping cool. I mean, that shot alone looks epic. So yes, it's a really, really good little game, and it might even look better than the PS2 version. Like I said, I'm going to do some comparisons one day, TM. So yes, I will do comparisons of the graphics, man. And apparently, I don't own this. I found it in the charity shop, and I was like, wait, I don't own this? The original Shrek game. I own every other Shrek game. Just not the first one. I don't know why, Donkey. I'm sorry. Extra large, extra funny, extra green. Oh, and extra onions, please. So they were saying loads of question marks, so maybe they don't think it's extra large and extra funny. I don't know. It's a Shrek game. I'm not saying any more about it. And I thought I owned this. But I don't. I own a Conan game for the PS3, but I'm assuming this is completely different because it's on the Xbox. Why would they put the same game on a different engine running it? It looked terrible. I don't know. Conan! Embark on the adventure of a lifetime. You guys know the story of Conan. It's a fantastic movie. If you haven't already seen it, watch it. Don't watch the remake. Conan. Excellent. Just kick ass. Next, Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. You guys know Splinter Cell. I'm not going to talk about Splinter Cell. You're joking. I want to get this video over and done with. The girlfriend found these ones, I remember now. Yeah. Mm. Yeah, you got... So yeah, she sometimes worked at a charity shop, so... When she went in, she found these.
Sometimes.
Yeah, because sometimes you're like, you can't be bothered. And it's like once a week, so... Or whatever.
Twice a week,
whatever. I don't care. So yeah, Splinter Cell... I already have it on Xbox. I have it on PC. Why the heck not own it on PS2? Whatever. That's the only reason I got it. And then she said Ben-Hur. And I was like, what? Ben what? Yeah, Ben-Hur. Spell out to me. Ben-H-U-R. Ben-Hur. What? And it's just like, it's Roman gladiatorial racing. Roman gladiatorial racing. I was like, get it. You know how much I love my Romans. Not so much gladiatorial racing, though. It's the one thing that put... Well, it was one of the few things that put me off Shadow of Rome. Confusing those games, though. Shadow of Rome on the PS2, one of the best games in the universe. If you've got a PS2, buy it. The combat system is the best. Stealth sucks. The gladiatorial racing sucks even harder. But the gladiatorial fight where you chop people up, really, really good. Graphics is brilliant for its time as well. So yeah, Race for Glory. Harness the reins of your chariot. Rule over your opponents with no mercy. Your goal to be revered by the gods themselves by bringing down terror and dominance over your opponents. Because only one can be victorious. Yay. Ben-Hur. Basically, you just go around in a chariot kicking ass. Awesome. Now, I bought the... Like, I was going to buy this from Sex a couple of weeks ago. But it was like... I think they said it was like £6 or £7. And I was like... No! I'm looking at eBay first. Found for £3 on eBay. I was like, mine. Ordered it, and it came a couple of days later. Boom. Super Dragon Ball Z. Master the unique fighting styles of 18 mighty Dragon Ball Z characters in this awesome fighting engine designed by... No, the guy of that. Basically, fighting engine designed by producer of Street Fighter 2. Producer. Producer. Not designer. Producer. Just saying. But yeah, unleash lightning quick combos and brutal finishing moves. Yeah, go you. It's a Dragon Ball game! Of course I'm gonna get it! You're joking, right? And apparently I didn't own this. Yeah. Now, I got it on PC. When it first came out, I got the big... not the big box, but you know the thick box that came with the map and everything and a couple of discs? Like, I'd install on the play disc and the box was, like, really thick as well. It was really good. Yeah, I got a PC. PC! Even back then, even back when I was a kid, I was a PC Master Race. Trying to be. But yeah, apparently I never owned it on PS2. That's what I did. I might own it on Xbox, maybe. Like a look. And even if I do, it's probably down there, isn't it? So, I think I own it on Xbox. But anyway, Gryffindor or Vice City. I don't own it. I had Vice City Stories. I had three. I have all of them. But apparently I didn't have this one, so whatever. I now have Vice City on PS2. You guys know Vice City. And guess what? It even comes with a manual. Awesome. And it doesn't open because it's tape shop. Quick PC game. I bought this just because it was freaking different. I just, like, we're looking through DVDs because charity shops don't really show the games very well. They just stuff them in with DVDs, thinking they're DVDs. Some people just don't know. And I just came across this one. It doesn't say PC on it or anything. I just looked at it because it looked different. Because I thought it just sounded like a weird movie. So I just gave it a look because it sounded like a weird movie. Falcon 4.0 Allied Force. I was like, what sort of bloody movie is that? Whatever. Experience the most realistic, challenging, and immersive air combat simulation you can get. And I was like, wait, that doesn't sound like a movie. It's a freaking game. It's like Falcon 4 Allied Force. Like, why? I'd never even heard of 1, 2, 3. I've not heard of any of them, but apparently it's pretty darn good, so I'm willing to give it a go. I mean, I've got my new flight stick thing, haven't I, that I bought a while ago. I think I've shown you it. Fairly certain I've shown you it. This thing. Yeah, I'm fairly certain, but anyway, I'll remind you guys. How did you get over there?
What?
Okay, I will not show you because somehow the cable for the webcam, which is right here, by the way, the cable goes down here, and I've plugged it into the computer, that's right here. Somehow the cable has gone and wrapped around the controller. How? The controller's all the way over there. Whatever. So anyway, yes, flight sim thing. And I bought a couple of Wii games. I think I should have sworn I bought three, but I don't know. Now, I only bought this one because the girlfriend says it's good.
Yes, it is.
Spectrobes Origins. But she played it on the PSP. So, I don't know, could be crap. But apparently it's two-player, so I want to make her suffer with me if it's bad. Spectrobes Origins on the Wii. Drop in, drop out, two-player co-op. 3D fossil excavation and over 100 unique creatures that you can, like, grow and shit and battle and shit. Something like that. Now, wait, if you played on the PSP, where is it? Give me.
I gave it to someone that I know.
She's horrible to me. Wait, you gave it to someone that you know because they took your DS.
I gave that person my DS because I wasn't using it anymore. And I gave that person my PSP. My games as well. Apart from the ones I bought here.
Should give it to me. Yeah. Spectrobes Origins. Basically, you just fly around, kick ass, and fight and excavate. I have no idea. She just said it was good. It was £3, so I bought it. I have no idea. I don't care. And apparently, we're adamant we own it.
What? I'm sure that we own it too.
Wait a minute. Behind you. Emergency Mayhem. Yeah. It was £2. And I could have sworn I picked it up before. Could have sworn. But I looked in the back and I've never played anything like that. Do I?
No.
It's not that, is it?
It's this one that I've seen.
Ah, see, we're thinking of Emergency Heroes. Emergency Mayhem. That's why this doesn't have similar games. But this is really flipping cool from the sounds of it. It's got a bunch of mini games, yeah? It's Mayhem in Crisis City. Oh, fuck, I'm not living there. Would you want to move to Crisis City? Oh, no. Fires rage, bombs are ticking, and monkeys have taken over the supermarket. Okay? Take the wheel of three emergency services as you race against the clock to get to the next crazy disaster. Use the Wii controls in wacky ways to solve unique crises. From disarming bombs to herding escaped penguins. What the fuck? Where did the penguins come from? Whatever. So yeah, it shows you driving around in an ambulance thing. Also shows you disarming a bomb with intricate wires and stuff, which is really cool. I look forward to doing that with the Wii. That sounds cool. And four-player party mode where you shoot monkeys with bananas or some shit. I had no idea. That's literally just monkeys. Yep, yep. Motherfuckers. I know it's a terrible game. There we go, see. No idea. Explore 8 environments in a huge city and share the mayhem with up to 4 players in party mode. It just sounds so dumb. I felt like I owned it. I checked my game list multiple times, couldn't find it. So, yeah, turns out we don't own it. It's only £2 as well. Can't go wrong. And that's it. It's over. We did it. 1 hour and 23 minutes later.
Oh, dear.
I apologize. I should have probably uploaded the last video, but I didn't because, I just didn't. Yeah, I recorded it like the weekend after Fallout 4 came out. I found some time to record it. I did. And then a whole bunch of games arrived like as soon as I finished recording. I was just like, fuck that. I can't be arsed adding it. Well, I was thinking about adding it, and then I didn't. And then I didn't re-upload the video, and then, yeah, that happened. And I figured if I uploaded that video the week after, it wouldn't sound right because I said that arrived like the other day, so like I don't like continuity issues in my videos. I like them to be okay. So yeah, I'm gonna get this rendered and uploaded today while I go through all of this and figure out where I'm gonna put it all, because I have too many games. Like as you guys know, I have a lot of shelves. Yep. They're all practically full. This is what I have right here. Yeah, freaking pile, a massive pile of games. That is part of the reason why I have another selling unit pretty much on the way. I don't have the space. I don't have the space to put the games. I don't have the space for more shelves. Catch 22, what do? Boxes. Boxes upon boxes of games. No, I'll never do that. I like to have them on shelves. So I have no idea what I'm going to do. I'm just going to make nice, neat piles now. I just need to figure it all out. Make piles of games, get them on the shelves somehow, and battle the winds. So anyway, guys, until next time. I'll think I'll make a little update video separate to this one, because I really doubt many people are going to be watching it this time. Mm-hmm. You guys know who you are when you're watching this time, because you guys always comment, because you guys are awesome. So I know you guys. But anyway, yeah, I think I'll make a quick update video later explaining a few things and saying what I'm planning to do, because I've got a lot of shit that I need to make public video-wise. Not that I'm gay or anything.
Am
I
gay?
Yes. You have a willy. The secret's out. No. Alright, I'll see you guys next time. Take care. Stay tuned for more scenes from the next episode of Dragon Ball Z.